我谁的卡拉古波尼古卡
卡
卡卡卡卡卡卡卡卡卡卡卡卡卡
卡卡卡卡卡卡
Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready?
Aquacha, Opanda Dipo, Quacha, Opanda Dipo, Quacha, Opanda Dipo.
Again, again, again.
Aquacha, Opanda Dipo, Quacha, Opanda Dipo, Quacha, Opanda Dipo.
Chop, 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 chop.
Come on.
Again. Shake your body, shake your body. Hussa. Tapo, 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 tapo. Hussa. Hussa. Chua, chua. Again. Okay. Put down.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Amen.
I thank God because of this precious night.
Ndikuthokoza Mungu kwa usiku unobambana.
And thank you for all of you for coming.
Komaso zongwambiri nonse chifukwa chobwera.
Coming for Jesus. Coming to receive from Him. And to humble ourselves to Jesus. I want to welcome all the delegates that they have come.
And to also
the High Commissioner of Zambia to Malawi.
High Commissioner of Zambia to Malawi.
The Mayor Snoya.
A Mayor Snoya.
From Chipata.
Choka nditu kushipata.
The Mayor Million.
Nditu Mayor Million.
That is all from Zambia.
Nditu chokera nso ku Zambia.
And the Honorable Member of Parliament.
Komaso nditu ole megezeka.
Cheka Chilenje.
Honorable Esther Cheka Chilenje.
The TA.
A TA.
We want to welcome all of you.
Tufuna nditu nonse tukulandileni.
And all the group that came from Zambia.
Nditu gulonse lojikulanso nditu ku Zambia.
And not forgetting
Osa Iwalanso.
My fellow Malawians.
Azinzanga onse ya Malawi.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I thank God because of everything.
Ndikuthokoza Mulungu chifukwa china chili chonse.
I have come with a very simple message.
Ndabwa nditu ndutenga wopweka chabe.
You know, when I was at the prayer mountain, this is a voice of God.
Ndapita nditu kukapemphera onde mawa Mulungu.
Remember tonight it is my night.
Kuti kumbukirani nditu usiku no ndusiku wanga.
That is what Jesus said.
Zimene Yesu ananena.
Go and heal the people.
Pidani mukajiritse anthu.
Deliver them.
Kamasuleni.
And set them free for a new beginning.
Ndipo mukamasule kuti akayambe chiyambi chatsopano.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So my coming tonight.
Kubwera kwanga usiku uno.
In your midst.
Pakati panu.
Is for Jesus to heal you.
Nzakuti Yesu akakuchiritseni.
Jesus to deliver you.
Yesu akakumasuleni.
Jesus to set you free.
Yesu akakumasuleni kwatunthu.
Jesus to restore your life.
Yesu akabwezeretse moyo wanu.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
But the question lies on this.
Koma funso lagona apa.
Have you allowed God's purpose to happen in your life?
Kodi mwalola cholinga cha Mulungu kuti chikachitike pa moyo wanu.
Most of us,
ambili aife,
we are not chasing God,
ife siti kutamangisa Mulungu,
but we want God to be chasing us.
But ufuna Mulungu yo azitamangisa ifeo.
Instead of us learning to Jesus,
maoti ife siti tamangira kwa Yesu,
We are busy
Tatanganika.
Asking Jesus to land our plans.
Kumbe mbanditu Yesu atamangile madongosolo watu.
All the people that were healed in the Bible.
Antu osea jamana jisidwa mbaibulo.
There were those that learned to Jesus.
Anali antu amene iwo natamangila kwa Yesu.
When you look the book of Luke chapter 8.
Mbuku la Luka 8.
From verse 32 to 48.
Kuyambia verse ya 32 mpaka na 48.
You are going to an amazing story. A woman who had an issue of blood after she stood for 12 years. She learned to Jesus. And that was her healing. There was a man also called Jairus who learned to Jesus and said to him, Lord
Jesus,
my daughter is sick. About to die. Can you learn and come home? Jesus was busy healing people. Before he knew, people came to Jairus. And he said to him,
Namuza,
Jairus, don't bother Jesus again. Your daughter is dead. But Jairus did not return home. And Jesus said to him, if you can believe, your daughter will live. No matter whatever situation in your life, whether it is dead, if you can believe, it will live. Whatever you have lost for many years, if you can believe, it will be restored tonight. The woman with an issue of blood, she allowed the purpose of God to manifest in her life. She learned to Jesus and embraced him by faith. The question we are having today, are you allowing the purpose of God to happen in your life? Most of us, we are living to our dreams. We are living to what we want. And we are trying to drag God into our plans. We are trying to drag Jesus into our plans. We are not allow his purpose to happen in our life. That is why there is so much disappointment in our relationships. There is so much disappointment in our marriages. Because we are learning our relationship, our marriage, the way people told us. We are not allowing the purpose of God to happen to us. That is why there is a lot of frustration in our jobs. Because we are living to ourselves. We are not allowing the purpose of God to happen to our life. Look at Jeremiah 29 verse 11 and
12.
Jesus says, for I the Lord I know the plans I have for you. Plans to give you future. Plans to give you hope. If you can come to me, pray to me, and seek me with all your heart, and I will be found by you. We are busy looking for the plans in life. When Jesus said, I have a plan for you, the plan of God is the purpose of God. God cannot come and do a miracle to your life if his purpose you have not allowed it. The purpose of God is to heal you. Is to heal you. But that healing cannot happen if you have not allowed that purpose to happen. You need to allow Jesus, his purpose, to manifest in your life. I mean, as you are starting this year, this is 2020.
Vision 2020.
If you want to see the fruits of this year, then you have to allow the purpose of God to happen in your life. When you allow His purpose, nothing is impossible with Jesus.